In this experiment, we will see how light behaves when it is reflected off a concave mirror. A spherical mirror is a mirror that has a curved surface. It can be considered as a part of a larger reflective sphere that was cut open. A concave mirror can be considered a part of a spherical mirror whose internal surface is the reflective surface. A convex mirror can be considered a part of a spherical mirror whose external surface is the reflective surface. Spherical mirrors reflect light falling on them differently from a flat mirror, and hence the images they produce are also different in nature. A light ray traveling parallel to the principal axis of a concave mirror will reflect off the mirror and pass through the focus point F. And a light ray passing through the focus point F will be reflected off a concave mirror parallel to the principal axis. Let us consider two light rays. First ray, indicated by the blue line, traveling parallel to the principal axis and passing through the top of an object. This ray gets reflected through the focus point F. And a second ray, indicated by the orange line, traveling through the top of the object and passing through the focus point F. This ray gets reflected parallel to the principal axis. Where these two rays meet after they get reflected off the concave mirror will decide the nature of the image formed by the mirror, such as the size, smaller or larger, direction, erect or inverted, location with respect to points C and F, and type, real or virtual. Note, objects in this experiment do not imply only incandescent objects. All observations made here hold good even for objects that are reflecting light from other sources. An incandescent object like candle has been used as the object in this experiment so that its image can be captured on an external screen. The light rays emerging from or getting reflected off an object travel in all directions. Also, rays could emerge from all parts of an object as shown below. However, we will be only considering the rays reflecting off the mirror for the purpose of our study. As only the two light rays mentioned earlier, the one traveling from the object and parallel to the principal axis and the other traveling through the focus point decide the nature of the image formed, only these two rays will be considered in our study. For clarity of pictorial representation, in the ray diagrams, we have shown the path of two light rays. One traveling parallel to principal axis, blue line, and the other traveling through the focus point, orange line, emerging only from the top of the object instead from the entire object. By understanding the path taken by these two rays, we can understand the type of image the mirror forms and how they differ with the position of the object with respect to the mirror. To understand the image formed by the mirror, we will place an object at varying distances from the mirror and identify the nature of the image formed and draw the corresponding ray diagrams. For this, we will need a concave mirror. The concave mirror we are using has a focal length of 10 centimeters. The focal length of the mirror is given on the packaging or the mirror cover. We will also need a white sheet of paper that will act as the screen, a candle and lighter or matches, a lens stand or piece of thermocol to hold the mirror, a measuring tape. If a measuring tape is not available, draw a line on a large sheet of paper using a pencil or pen, or on the floor using a chalk and ruler. On the tape or the line that you have drawn, mark points C, F and P. The distance between points C and F and points F and P is equal to the focal length of the mirror that you are using. In our case, we have marked points C, F and P 10 centimeters apart from each other. The point C represents the center of curvature of the mirror. The point F, the focus or the focal point of the mirror. And point P is where we will place the mirror. Place the mirror at point P and place the candle, which is our object, beyond point C. Move the white sheet of paper that is acting as our screen from point P, where the mirror is kept, towards point C until a clear image of the candle flame is formed on the screen as shown. You will notice a clear image is formed between point C and point F. When the object is placed at a point beyond point C, the ray from the object traveling parallel to the principal axis, the blue line, gets reflected through the focus point F, and the ray from the object traveling through the focus point F, the orange line, gets reflected parallel to the principal axis. These two rays will meet at a point between C and F. The image formed is smaller than the actual size of the object, inverted and real in nature as it could be captured on a screen. Now, move the candle to the point C. Again, move the white sheet of paper that is acting as our screen from point P towards point C till a clear image of the candle flame is formed on the screen. You will notice a clear image is formed at point C. When the object is placed at point C, the ray from the object traveling parallel to the principal axis, the blue line, gets reflected through the focus point F, and the ray from the object traveling through the focus point F, the orange line, gets reflected parallel to the principal axis. These two lines meet at point C. As seen in the ray diagram, the image formed is inverted in nature and of the same size as the object. The image is real in nature as we could capture it on a screen. Now, place the candle between the point C and F. Move the screen away from the mirror towards point C and beyond till a clear image is formed. You will notice a clear image is formed beyond point C. Place the candle between the points C and F. Move the screen away from the mirror towards point C and beyond till a clear image is formed. You will notice a clear image is formed beyond point C. When the object is placed between C and F, the blue line and the orange line meet at a point beyond point C. The image formed is larger than the actual size of the object, inverted and real in nature as it could be captured on a screen. Now, place the candle at the focus point F. Move the screen away from the mirror towards point C and beyond till a clear image is formed. You will notice there is no clear image formed when the object is placed at point F. This is because when the candle is placed at F, the blue line and the orange line, after getting reflected off the mirror, travel parallel to each other and never meet. As these two rays don't meet, no image is formed.
Lastly, place the candle between point F and the mirror. Move the screen away from the mirror towards point C and beyond till a clear image is formed. You will notice there is no clear image formed on the screen. But if you look into the mirror, an enlarged image of the candle is visible in the mirror. This is because when the object is placed between F and P, the blue and orange line, after getting reflected off the mirror, travel away from each other and do not meet. However, if these rays are extended backwards as shown by the dotted lines in the ray diagrams, the rays will meet to form an image inside the mirror. As seen in the ray diagram, the image formed is erect in nature and larger than the object in size. The image is virtual in nature as it could not be captured on a screen.